kit. Okay, good news, it's been coated twice, so we've had the paper tape through here. Skimmed over the top, we'll put this second coat on. And then between coats, I like to scratch back like this. I don't sand. This base coat doesn't really sand, so don't worry about doing that. Make sure there's no dust, and you're ready to put it on. This is pre-mixed topping compound. Sands really well. Sometimes when you put it over previously painted surfaces, it bubbles. And you can't do too much about that, you just have to come back at the end. Pretty happy with that. That'll stand out pretty good. You might get some bubbles, but like I said, it's just some pinholes. But you can just sand it out and give it another skim coat. And it takes a couple minutes to dry after that. Another little patch we did. I think it was probably from the door handle. Sorry, had a few coats. Scraped back. Nothing in the way. A big blade going over the old size patch. When it comes to sanding, when it's dry, you sand the edge, nice and gradual, and then feather in the middle, these little things here, and you should be good. Okay, so in case you didn't notice, it's actually the next day after I set these. And they're all dry now, and I just want to show you sort of how you sand these. First, you start with the edges. And this goes with every kind of sanding, every patch, every joint. Hit the edges. That's all gradual. And then you've just got a little bit of middle. Now, we left the middle quite flat as it was, so then we get a little bit. Just to buff out any spots. Make sure you run your hand over it. And that's good. Same thing again. Hit that edge. It's a good idea to carry a little blade with you, so you can scratch back and get nice clean edges. So just doing the edges. Feels pretty good. So you should probably use a vacuum, but I just packed mine away and I'm too lazy to get it out. But this will work all the same. Not too bad. You can really see it when you put a sealer coat on. But that's pretty good. That's fixed.